Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Brothers and sisters, we take this time to acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to meet the Lord in word and in sacrament. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. This word came to Jeremiah from the Lord. Rise up, be off to the potter's house. There I will give you my message. I went down to the potter's house, and there he was, working at the wheel. Whenever the object of clay which he was making turned out badly in his hand, he tried again, making of the clay another object of whatever sort he pleased. Then the word of the Lord came to me. Can I not do to you, house of Israel, as this potter has done? Says the Lord. Indeed, like clay in the hand of the potter, so are you in my hand, house of Israel. The word of the Lord. Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God while I live.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Put not your trust in princes, in the sons of men in whom there is no salvation. When his spirit departs, he returns to his earth. On that day, his plans perish.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Blessed he whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them.
Blessed is he whose help is the God of Jacob.
Sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. God and separate the wicked from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things? They answered, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. When Jesus finished these parables, he went away from there. The Gospel of the Lord. One of the ways we, the church, the baptized, can understand ourselves is as the new Israel. So when the Lord reveals to the prophet Jeremiah that he can mold Israel as the potter molds clay in his hands, we can hear that revelation as directly related to us as well. Just as the Israelites were molded in the midst of many difficult and trying circumstances, we too were invited to allow the Lord to mold us in the midst of our current difficult and trying circumstances. And even though there are many similarities between us and the Israelites, there's a huge difference. We are incredibly blessed to be born after Christ has come into the world. The fullness of the revelation of the lengths God is willing to go to redeem us, to save us from our sins, is made manifest in Christ on the cross. The image of the potter with his eyes fixed on that piece of clay now takes the shape of the Eucharist that we are about to receive. The daily celebration of the Eucharist is a reminder of God's presence with us always and his desire to give himself to us completely. It is a reminder that he never takes his eyes off us, not for a moment. Today, as we receive him, before we approach him in the Eucharistic host, we ask for the grace to be open to all that he wishes to give us this day, so that we can be more perfectly molded into the men and women he created us to be the men and women he desires us to be here and now. And this is not just for our own salvation, this is for the sake of the salvation of those around us. For our brothers and sisters who are waiting, whether they realize it or not, they are waiting to hear of his love for them. Through being open to the action, the molding action of the Holy Spirit, we can become the saints God calls us to be. He set the world on fire with his love, even if it's just in a small act of kindness that opens the hearts of those around us to his grace. That love is redeeming. It can fix any mess that we make, forgives any sin that we confess. And if we ask for that grace to be open to his molding action, we don't need to fear the end of time when the angels will separate the wicked from the righteous. Christ has paid the price of our salvation. And it is through him who offers himself to us again this day that we can be molded and participate in his saving redemption. For us, and for all those who are open to his love and to his mercy. And although it seems like the clay, which represents our current circumstances, may have fallen off the table as a blob on the floor, we are called to see our present reality with the eyes of faith. The potter is at work. His eyes are fixed on his loving people. His healing hands are around the hearts of those open to his grace. Blessed indeed are they whose help is the God of Jacob.
Let us pray. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Archbishop Gregory Amon, Bishop Ferdinand Cherie, for all of our priests, our deacons, barred religious. We pray too for our seminarians, especially those who are new and coming to us to study for the priesthood in the coming week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord, for the leaders of governments throughout the world and for peaceful hearts and for the safety of all people, especially our military, our police, our first responders, those in the front line of medical care. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord, especially for our seventh graders moving on to high school as we celebrate with them this evening a Mass, sending them prayerfully forward, mindful of the foundation that they were given here at St. Anne's School. We pray for an outpouring of the Holy Spirit over them and the guidance of St. Anne as they move forward. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord, for those we bring here in our hearts prayerfully, especially those who are maybe sick in any way, those in a hospital, those recovering from a surgery, or maybe those near death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray, Lord, through the intercession of our Lady of Prompt Succor, for the Lord's protection, so as to keep us safe from every harm to life and property during this hurricane season. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Glory be to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be. Glory be to God. St. Anne,
pray for
St.
us.
St. Joachim,
pray for
Blessed Francis, Savior, see
pray for us.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual joy. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good
of all this holy church. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from your abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And with the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give thanks, Father, most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. Fulfilling your will and gaining for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and saints, we declare your glorious with one voice, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Gregory our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and for by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God and the glory of the Lord
now. O Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Please bow.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away. away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Sacraments live stream, I invite you to pray with me the spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. We have consumed all of this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the Passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may it profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.